Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel and welcome to my new subscribers, and thank you for all the lovely comments and your stories. Keep them coming because I love hearing from you guys. So today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. So we're going to be looking at the enchanted map cards. Okay, so this is a guide to explore the path that you're on, okay, and better understand yourself as well, and your purpose. So it's like a help with relationships or a help with your job, just overall help basically. So take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Don't force anything, okay guys. So for group one we have the ruby pin, group two we have the aquamarine pin, and for group three we have the pink pin. So I'll see you at your piles, guys. Okay, hey pile one, so if you chose the ruby pin, this is your reading. So let's have a look. So we've got past, okay, which is the magic prayer, okay, so that's your past. Then we have for present, okay, is the Ori desert. I was gonna say dessert. Oh god, craving sugar. And for your future here we have flying. Okay, so let's have a look before I go into the tarot cards. Okay, so with the so with the magic prayer card, in the past you were connected to spirit, okay, you were in alignment, you were well balanced, okay, so you were in touch with your higher self as well as your, you know, your angels and your spirit guides, okay. Which was really good. So it's like something that you, you know, was manifesting or praying or talking to your, you know, your ancestors or your spirit guides, okay, the divine, and you were asking them for. So you were really excited about something here, but then all of a sudden, with the present right now, you lost this inspiration along the way. It's like, okay, what I'm hearing here is you used to speak to spirit, you were in touch with the universe and everything here, but then I feel like with you guys that once you got into the thing that it is that you were wanting and communicating, you forgot to talk to spirit. It's like you got sidetracked and you became focused on what it was that you wanted. So what had happened was things started to dry up. You then became adaptable to the environment that you were in, you know, because if you look at the desert, things have to adapt in the desert because it's really, really dry, isn't it? So you just started plodding along, just started, I don't know, you just settled. I feel like you just settled. And spirit wants you to know as well, group one, if you feel you're in the wrong environment, okay, or wrong relationship, we'll see what it is when I do the tarot. Spirit is saying looks can actually be deceiving. You actually may be in the right environment. I hope you understand what I'm saying. So if you're having doubts and thinking I shouldn't be here or I shouldn't be in this relationship, looks can be deceiving, okay? You may not be seeing the bigger picture. And now, with the present here, Spirit is saying that you've gone through a very challenging time at the moment, okay? And opportunities are now becoming available to you once again. So you've gone from past talking, communicating with Spirit, then you've gone from being stuck, not communicating, not feeling in alignment with yourself. And then I feel like maybe what's happened here with the future, you may have realized, crap, I stopped speaking to the divine, and now you're back in alignment with yourself, okay? Because it's like you've just gone full circle here. You went through good, you went through a rough time, then you're going through a good, okay? Or you could be going, transitioning into good now, because this is the future card, the flying card, okay? So in the future, You are in alignment with your higher purpose, okay? If you've been waiting for something, the waiting is going to be over. Hard work is going to start paying off for you. And Spirit is saying, reach for the stars, okay? Dream big with that flying card there. So it's really positive, okay? So let's have a look. Okay. So tell me more about the magic prayer here, Spirit, please. I'm gonna clarify each card because I want to know for in the past what it was. Tell me about the magic prayer for group one, please. So we have the Hangman, we have the Nine of Wands, and we have the Three of Wands. Ten of Cups. For you guys, group one, I feel like this is a relationship, it's not work, okay? I feel like what you were communicating to Spirit was that, when am I going to get my happily ever after with the Ten of Cups, okay? You were all about, like, when is that relationship going to come in? When is it going to happen for me here? So there was this yearning, okay? This was like this waiting and yearning and, you know, because what it was, you were wounded in the past by maybe previous relationships. And also I feel like the waiting and the yearning was affecting you as well, was, you know, hurting you. But you know what? You stood your ground here. You were very persistent in that way. You were very persistent in communicating to Spirit what it was that you were hoping for. And I feel like with the Hangman here, you decided that you wasn't going to settle for anything less. You decided to put boundaries in place for yourself. You know, and also the Hangman is enlightenment. And this is what I'm saying, you are in touch with the divine here. And I feel like once you got your Ten of Cups, which is happily ever after here, okay, which is a commitment, you know, it could be marriage, you could have started a family with someone here. Things dried up in the present. I feel like maybe it's not going well, it's not progressing to the stage that you want it to get to. So what's happened here is that you've become out of touch with Spirit here, okay? And I feel like Spirit is saying to you, speak to us again. We're there to help you. So tell me about this Ten of Cups, please, for group one. You know what you got, you know that saying, all that glitters is not gold or something like that. So what's happened to you here, you got the dream, you got the relationship that you wanted, but it didn't turn out the way you wanted it to be. And I feel like that is why you turned your back on talking to Spirit here, talking to, you know, the universe, or manifesting anything here, because it was like, well, I wanted my Ten of Cups here, but you sent me a Knight of Wands, somebody that is immature, somebody that has a player energy here, somebody that's not faithful, okay, someone that can be quite reckless. They didn't bring you any they didn't bring you any security here. So you were still yearning for something else here. You know, this is the wish card. So you were still wishing that this person could have been that person for you, but then it turned out that just really wasn't the person for you. You know, I feel like you, because this person hurt you with the nine of wands here, you turned your back on them, okay? This is going cold towards someone, just a breakdown of a relationship, communication. But here is, now, we do have the star here, which is healing. And I feel like I'm hearing spirit say that your wishes in your grasp, if it hasn't already happened for you. So we've got Aquarius, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius as well. But you have healed from this, but it's like now with the present here, it's like what is the point in being with anybody when all they do is they just keep hurting me? It's like I keep hearing you guys say I keep attracting these players, you know, these people that just don't have or they have commitment issues, you know. So let's have a look at Ori Desert, please, spirit, for group one. Seven of Wands, the Sun, here we go, Eight of Wands. Oh, and the King of Coins. So for some of you, if you were still in the past with this Knight of Wands and you thought, I'll give it a go, you know, and you set some boundaries with this person. For some of you with this person, you know, because Seven of Wands is protecting yourself, okay, protecting yourself as well as standing up for what you believe in, what is right, okay, you know, wanting that respect, okay, you demand that respect because you deserve that, okay. So you're looking to the future for happiness here with the Sun, and I feel like you told this person, if you can't get it together, I'm moving on. So for some of you, this person may have decided, okay, I want to be with group one, and I'm going to mature and I'm going to become responsible, the King of Coins here, and I'm going to settle down, I'm going to marry, I'm going to be a provider, you know, I'm going to take care of my family. And this could have been communicated to you. If this hasn't happened and you did get rid of the Knight of Wands here, this is somebody else that Spirit is saying is on its way to you, is somebody that now is a king who will look after you, who will provide for you, who will remain faithful to you, okay? And this is going to be happening very quickly with the Eight of Wands. This is going to heal you, it's going to heal your soul, you're going to finally coming into alignment here again, you know, you're going to have that connection with the divine again, with the Sun. This is overall happiness here. And the nice thing about this King of Coins, between the both of you, you are going to communicate boundaries, okay? There's going to be mutual respect here. There is no this King of Coins crossing any boundaries with you or you with them. And these four cards here are really beautiful to see. And you know what is really nice is seeing the Moon on the back of the deck, is that your feelings and emotions for this King of Coins is going to run really deep. It's going to be so deep, and so is his or hers for you. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. You know, Spirit is saying to you, you don't have to adapt. As I said to you guys about adapting to a situation, you know, just accepting it is what it is. And Spirit is saying here that you do not need to adapt to anything. You do not need to settle for second best. You do not need to settle for this player energy here, which is the Knight of Wands. You deserve your King of Wands over here. you deserve respect, you deserve love, you deserve happiness. I mean, we can go on and on about the sun, because the sun is beautiful and so is the star. You've literally got two beautiful cards here. Your past was manifestation, you know, communication with the universe, with the spirit guides, and now you've got the sun here, and you're finally becoming, you're finally being put back together is what I'm hearing here. Okay, group one. So let's have a look at flying. So tell me about flying. So, you know, your life purpose here, or the lesson that you needed to learn through this journey here, is the boundaries that needed to be set. Not just settling for Unite of Wands here, that's, to be honest, an idiot. You know, even though they were promising you the Ten of Cups here, they were empty promises. So your lesson here was you didn't need to settle for anything here. You don't need to be wounded. You set the boundaries. You know, look at the respect on her face. You know, the contentment. I mean, I see this as a really, I love this. It's a powerful card. I mean, and then you look at him as well. Don't forget, these are energies that can be female. Look how strong he is. And that's what you deserve. So tell me about flying, please, Spirit. Oh, look how you guys come out as the Empress. So we've got the Devil in reverse, Ten of Wands in reverse, the King of Swords in reverse, and the Lovers in reverse, and then the Empress. Very interesting cards here. So we've got Capricorn, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You know, you overcame people being Klingons here with this flying here. You're leaving toxicity, toxic people, people with addictions, people with problems, people with, you know, narcissistic traits, because we have the King of Swords in reverse here. You literally just left that behind. It's like you've got no time for people like this anymore. You know, you're done with the mind games and the control, you know, the mind control and things like that with the Devil energy in reverse. You're done with it. And then the Ten of Wands in reverse. You know, you realized that there was just too many responsibilities, too many problems with this Knight of Wands here. You know, whoever you were with or whoever you were dealing with, it was just there was just no getting around it, no getting over it. And it was like, why am I putting myself through this? You literally have a King of Swords in reverse here, which is awful for you guys, if that's who you were dealing with. This is someone that is like power crazy. You know, you've got the Devil, you've got the King of Swords here. King of Swords in reverse is a narcissist. They're aggressive, they're brutal, they're violent, they're controlling, they're rude, they have no integrity here. And I feel like this is why everything just dried up here. It's like you didn't get what you wanted to. And you know, sometimes we do, that does happen. I've done it. You know, I'm always in contact, and it's like a phone call to my spirit guide. But I have to stay in touch with spirit, because, you know, I do these, but it sounds really weird. But sometimes I think to myself, what is the point? But then I snap out of it, because I think to myself, you know, there is a higher purpose of what is the point. And I feel like that is what you guys were feeling at the time, in the past and the present, is what is the point? Why am I doing this to myself? And you need to be honest with yourself here and maybe accept that this person doesn't love you, okay? Because lovers in the reverse can be unrequited love. It could also be that you don't love this person no more. You've fallen out of love with them. this is a separation, this is conflict in a relationship, is feeling unloved. There's an imbalance, and that's why you ended up at Swords here, because you got two really positive cards either side of that middle card there, where you were in alignment, you were in communication with spirit, and it just went away because this devil energy, which I've already explained in a number of my readings, is there to distract you from your greater good, from your, you know, from the divine here, because you're of light. I mean, for goodness sake, guys, you've come out as the Empress here and the High Priestess. I mean, bloody hell. Two powerful cards in the tarot deck you've come out as. You are somebody that is really valued in the spiritual world here by your spiritual team, by the divine, okay? Very, like, really, really valued. You have a good heart, you're kind, you have empathy for people. And this is the problem, because you are the Empress, and I say this all the time, people take advantage of the Empress. But she's not weak, not at all. You guys are not weak, it's just that you have such beautiful hearts. And then what happens? Because you're the Divine Feminine, the devil always has to be involved in this to you know, send you on the wrong path, you know, distract you from your purpose. You've got a gift here as well, guys, of intuition, psychic abilities here. You know, some of you can be empaths and clairvoyants and clairaudience, you know. But also with the High Priestess, spirit is actually shouting at you right now. The High Priestess saying, please open up, talk to us, listen to us. We're there to help you. So your future is you flying away from this toxic situation right down here. If some of you haven't met the King of Coins yet, he's there. But don't, it's like I'm hearing, don't give up. Don't turn away from, you know, what's meant to be. So let's get advice from spirit for you guys, okay? I feel like I've really told you guys off. I don't mean, I hope it didn't come across like that, because I did mean to, but it's just, it is really sad when you've got a person. I mean, and I'm going to be honest with you guys, right? I've been doing this, I'm now 50 years old. I've been doing this since I first picked up my tarot deck. I was 16 years old. And that's when I got into it. And I have always done tarot, okay, for friends, family. Never something like this. But then I got involved with somebody. And they didn't like the idea of tarot cards. And I would get told off. I would get, you know, like the King of Swords. I don't want to go into too much detail about, you know, my personal thingy. But it wasn't nice. So what happened? I turned away from my purpose. I put my cards away and I did not touch them for years. For years. And then one day, I just literally, I think it was about 7 years ago. I don't know. I think spirit must have come knocking on the door saying, you need to go back to what, you know, the gift that you were given here, and you need to start sharing it again. So I did. So, you know, if you're on a purpose here and there's something that you're supposed to be doing, you're supposed to be meeting your King of Coins here, don't turn away from it. Anyway, so let's have a look at the advice for you guys. What's the advice for Group 1? Page of Pentacles. Oh, wow, beautiful. Spirit is saying here with this Page of Coins here, you're about to be leveling up. in spirit's eyes here, you know, this has become quite spiritual, this reading for you guys. You're about to level up. There is something about you, and you know, we've got the High Priestess and the Empress here, and the leveling up is this Ace of Coins here. This is the divine, you know, usually it's a hand with the coin in you know, the palm or the hands, saying here is your second chance or a new chance at a new beginning here. So whether this is a relationship you want or a career change or moving or finances, you know, you can't get better than the Ace of Coins. You know, and these two here are about leveling up. They're saying to you that you are someone who is valuable to them. Okay, so maybe you've got a gift, like what I was saying here about my gift. Maybe you guys have got some kind of gift here that you should be using as well. I really need to shut that window because it's really getting on my nerves. And I feel like I'm going to clarify him. Tell me about this King of Coins, please. I feel like this King of Coins is going to bring so much wealth, but not as in finances, just something really wonderful, you know, for you guys. It's something really special that's coming in for you here. You know, everything's about to pay off, as I said, with this flying card. You don't need to adapt to people or situations. You don't need to be what other people want you to be. You be yourself, your authentic self. And I feel like this King of Coins is somebody that wants you to be your authentic self. So we have strength, Two of Wands, and the Page of Cups. Oh, look, this is your soulmate. This is your soulmate, guys. Okay, Two of Cups, can't get any better than that. So if you've already met this person, you've already gone through this journey, and you're with someone and you're sitting there saying to yourself, yep, I've met my soulmate, I'm happy, just be reassured that that is this, the person that you're with is your soulmate, okay? They love you very deeply, because we do have the Queen of Cups, which also is psychic and an empath. So maybe there's something else that you need to be pursuing as well. Yeah, and I'm on about spiritually. You know, magic prayer is all about meditation. So maybe you've stopped meditating. Maybe life got in the way and you stopped doing it. You stopped communicating with spirit. Spirit wants you to carry on doing that. Spirit sees you as someone very strong. And this King of Coins admires that strength in you, okay? They admire the battles that you've gone through. They love that about you. They love that you left behind people or situations that, you know, wasn't doing you any good. They respect that about you as well, because come on, we've got the strength, we've got Leo energy here as well, and then we have Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well. So for some of you with the Page of Cups, this could be, some of you could be pregnant, some of you could be, you know, wanting a child with this King of Coins, but you could already have children with them. And may, oh, okay, Spirit. Ah. That's your purpose. Your purpose is, don't make my throat go funny. Do you not want me to say? Bear with me, guys. Spirit may not want me to say. Hang on a minute. Clarify the Page of Cups. This is unexpected. Four of Wands. Okay, your purpose here, guys, is that a child that you and the King of Coins is... Oh, God, get it out. So the child that you and the King of Coins is going to have or is about to have here, which, like I said, can be an unexpected pregnancy here, an unexpected child that you wasn't expecting. Maybe some of you have had trouble getting pregnant. Some of you may not have wanted children. There is something with this child that is very special to the divine, okay? Very special. Four of Wands, family, twin flame card here. This is a celebration. Spirit is saying, if some of you have not wanted children, and some of you may be confused about having children, this is something to celebrate, Spirit is saying, because there's something very special about the birth of a child here. And I feel like with the tower here, that's why I hesitated and asked my spirit guides, do you not want me to say? And I feel like spirit doesn't want me to say it anymore because the tower is next to this child here. So it's like I'm just hearing them say, leave it. It's not for you to know. It's not for you to know, neither group one. And I'm sorry if that, you know, you're disappointed, but sometimes you don't push it. But there's a birth of a child here that is very valuable to the divine here. I'd love to know what it is. I hate not knowing. So there you go. There's your purpose, guys, is this child. I'd keep hearing volunteer with this Page of Cups, this child. It's like they've volunteered. I know that sounds really crazy, but we do. We volunteer to be. They say we choose our parents. We volunteer to come back, you know, with karma and things like that for our ancestors. And all I'm hearing with this Page of Cups is I volunteer. It's like they chose you. So if you see something very magical about your child, you know, maybe my son used to do that when he was little, really like regularly. If you see your child talking to someone or noticing things or saying things that are not there and you're like, what the hell is he or she on about? They've got a connection with spirit, okay? There's a gift here and I feel the gift comes from you. As well as your King of Coins. Very magical group this is. This is a very beautiful group. So let's get some angel messages for you, okay, group one. See, but as soon as the Page of Cups come out my throat, it's like, obviously you can hear it. It's like, when that happens, sorry, I need to take a drink. When that happens, it's usually either someone you've channeled doesn't want you to speak, or obviously spirit doesn't want me to speak anymore about this child, this gift. So what? Right, okay, bloody hell, right, spirit. So we've got moonlighting. You can start working on your dream career part-time while keeping your other job to pay the bills. Soon your dream career will take flight and fully support you. Seriously. Do you know what? I feel like I said too much. All right, spirit. Jesus. I think that's the most I've ever been choked. Whew. So let's do that again. I apologize, guys. You can start working on your dream career part-time while keeping your other job to pay the bills. Soon your dream career will take flight and fully support you. So wait. Hang on a minute. Then let go of guilt. When you allow your light to shine brightly, you inspire others. Forgive yourself for what you think you've done or not done and trust that God loves you unconditionally for who you are. Learn to grow from past mistakes instead of berating yourself for them. So now look, three cards came out here, okay? So I'm literally seeing, I'll read this one in a minute. I'm literally seeing that these three cards are literally going with your three cards up there. So for some of you could have been the one that was working multiple jobs to supply, I don't know, this devil energy in reverse here, trying to keep the home together, trying to keep the bills paid. There could have been stuff where you guys were struggling because we did have the five of coins, and that is poverty. And if this person did have drug addictions, you're having to carry the load, and that's what the Empress does. Okay, she carries the load. So, for some of you may have found the career that you finally settled into and you're very happy about it. And with this here, let go of the guilt. This goes with this Ori desert there. Let go of the guilt that you're holding on to. If you're beating yourself up about whether you feel guilty about leaving this person to move on, and that, because people make you feel guilty, you don't need to, is what spirit is saying. You just need to think about yourself here. If you're feeling guilty about, I feel like you guys are beating yourself up about, is why did I stay? Why did I put up with this? Or what is wrong with me? Or what was wrong? Stop doing that, is what the angels are saying here. Okay? And then we have ask for your needs to be met. God and the angels come to your aid only if you make a free will choice to be helped. And it begins with asking. It doesn't matter how you ask God for help, but only that you do so. The same holds true with clearly asking other people to assist you. Then this is the problem. I said you guys closed off from spirit. It was like you just the line went dead, basically. You stopped communicating with spirit. And if you guys have done that and you're still doing it, you need to start communicating with them again, because you really do need to. I'm just hearing that. There's a re really important message here for you. So, hang on, let me see. Let's get some moon cards for you guys as well. A fiery climax approaches, full moon in Aries. So, for some of you, if you still are involved in this devil energy over here, it's about to just climax, finish. And then we have a new start is coming. There you go. You have got a very happy future ahead of you here, group one, okay? One more, please, spirit. One more. Thank you. All right, then two more. Meditate and contemplate. Now, I said it could be that you stop meditating, so start meditating. The answers you need are coming. I like that. So, group one, I'm going to leave it there. I hope this resonated. If you like the video, please hit like. And you have a lovely evening, guys. Much love. Hey, group two. So, if you chose the Aquamarine pin, this is your reading. So, let's look at your cards. We've got coming to life, which is your past. We have your present, which is making a choice. And then for the future, we have Oregon's lair. Lair. Anyway, sorry. So guys, okay. So with your past here, guys, you were somebody that was reckless, free spirited, you took risks, you took chances, you weren't scared of anything. And the wonderful thing about you, group two, is you have a remarkable internal warning system, okay? Like your intuition was is always on point, okay? And you entered into something quite dangerous. It was the thrill of it that you really was drawn to, even though your warning system, it's like your alarm system, was telling you, abort is what I'm hearing, but you just took that chance, so this can be a relationship, this could have been a job, we're going to clarify each card. And you knew that when you were getting involved with whatever it was that you got involved with group two, okay, that you knew it was going to be a huge challenge. And you knew internally that it was going to change you forever. So that's what I'm seeing there come into life with that card, with your past. Now we have the present, which is making a choice. So now you're at this fork in the road, group two, okay? You've got a choice that you need to make. And the nice thing about you guys, you don't point fingers at nobody. You knew what you were getting yourself into, and it's like you're taking full responsibility for your actions, your past mistakes, the choices that you made. So you're not a victim, or you don't project onto other people. You own your mistakes, group two. So much respect to you guys. But you do have a choice that you need to make, and spirit wants you to know, don't be afraid. Now is not the time to be afraid, okay? And trust your intuition, trust that warning system that was, you know, that you have, and look for the signs from spirit with that card. There's signs that's already being given to you. Don't ignore them. It won't lead you wrong. And then with your future. So with your future here, this is a really lovely card, because spirit is saying, can you see how much you have grown and matured from your past experiences here, the choices that you made? You've matured into someone that you should actually be proud of. So it's like you've evolved. And spirit is saying with this dream, with this dragon's lair here, there's a dream or a wish that you've been manifesting, and this is about to become a big reality here. This is a really exciting card for you guys, for your future. So let's get your tarot cards, and I'm going to clarify each tarot card, each oracle card, okay? So let's look at your past. Let's see what happened. I haven't used these cards in ages. I missed these cards. So tell me about coming to life for group two. For group two. Yes. Yeah, five of wands. Okay. So tell me more about this coming to life. Seven of swords. The sun. Ten of wands. Okay, look, it's exactly what I said. You know, there was an inner battle going on with you guys when you made this choice. You knew, like, it was dangerous. You knew that you were going to get backlash for it from other people. You may have had people coming down on you. But you knew what you were getting yourself into, and you just took that chance because, you know, you just thought to yourself, never going to know if unless I try it. What ended up happening to you guys in the past was you may have dealt with somebody. Look, it may have been that you were in denial, not wanting to face the truth that this, whatever it was that you got involved with here, it could have been a job, it could have been a relationship. I mean, we do have the Three of Pentacles on the back of the deck, so it could be a career, but I'm not going to pick that up because I'm not sure yet. So you could have just been in denial about what was in front of you. You know, that may have been the time that you literally did not listen to your intuition. And there may be a part of you that wishes that you did, but sometimes our past mistakes make us who we are today. So you've healed from this, okay? At one stage, whatever this was, it brought you a lot of happiness here, but you have healed from it. You saw the light, you started seeing whatever this was, because I'm still not getting a clarification here yet. you were enlightened to what was surrounding this thing here. You ended up in the Ten of Wands, which brought you problems and trouble, burdens, stress, anxiety. A lot of responsibility as well. So let's have a look. What was this spirit? Tell me about this. Tell me about this Seven of Swords, please. What was the Seven of Swords for group two? Four of Swords. Mental exhaustion, feeling drained. Who is this Seven of Swords? I don't think so. Oh, there you go. Nine of Wands, somebody who wounded you, somebody that was a karmic. Two of Swords. Eight of Swords, you're in a mental prison. Look, you went into something you were excited about, a new beginning here, but you ended up in the Eight of Swords. I mean, this is really like a lot of negative cards here, guys. Like I said, a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, a lot of, you know, I feel like your mental illness, you struggled with mental illness here. You may have even, for some of you, okay, so a bit of a trigger warning here, okay? You may have even had a breakdown as well. Things started going from bad to worse for you, group two. And you tried to protect yourself. You tried to... What was this? You did. You tried to protect yourself, but it was like... Maybe it was part of karma for you guys that, you know, maybe there was that little bit of karmic debt that you had to pay off, you know, maybe for past actions. It could be past actions of your ancestors, but your fortune started to turn. What happened here, please, Spirit, for group two? Group two is always my difficult pile. Every time, near enough in every reading I do, difficult. Tell me about what happened here. Okay, so you're getting on my nerves. Sorry, guys. Tell me what happened here, please, Spirit. So we've got Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Right, you know what? I'm taking them because, really. So let's keep that one because that flew out of that one. So then we've got the Nine of Cups. We've got the King of Cups. You've got the King of Swords, a divorce or a separation here. The Two of Swords again. So you've got that twice now. Then the Magician. So we've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, strong air sign in this reading. Now, the King of Swords and the Queen of Swords is two people that are not seeing eye to eye, okay? They're constantly arguing, okay? They've got nothing in common. And then it turned out that you're having to protect yourself. That's like the Nine of Wands. You're having to defend yourself constantly, you know. You saw this person, so this was a relationship, somebody you got involved with, your intuition was screaming at you that this is, you know, danger, run the other way, but you took that chance because that is what you wanted to do. Now I feel here you had an energy here with two types of personalities. One that was very cold. Half the time they would be cold with you, then the next minute they'd be loving. So, okay, thanks, Spirit. I'm hearing love bombing here. Because the King of Cups is somebody that's in love, he's affectionate, he's charming. He's everything thrown in there. And then you've got the King of Swords that is cold, distant, logical, detached, you know, not doesn't show emotions, doesn't get emotionally invested in things, or, you know, if you're expecting tears from a King of Swords, don't expect it. So you ended up with somebody that would love bomb you, then you ended up with someone that turned into a narcissist. So you were literally getting, you didn't know who you were getting on what day, okay, group two? This is why there was a warning of danger here at the beginning of the reading. But you ignored all the signs that spirit was trying to show you. It's like you, we know with these two cards, it was like you didn't want to see the truth, even though the truth was there, you know. But it's like I say, sometimes we've got to do this because these are our life lessons that we have to go through. So you're either divorced from this person or you're separated from this person. This person ended up becoming very selfish, very entitled. You didn't end up with what you thought you were getting. You ended up with somebody that was master at their craft, here, you know, master at manipulation, master at controlling you. Master, you know, playing games with you, because the King of Cups can play games as well, emotional games. We've got Aquarius on the back of the deck as well, which is healing energy. So you manifested this, you know, this is what you wanted. You wanted someone that was on, you know, I feel like group two, you guys like that bit of danger in someone, you know, but it went sour. It went sour very quickly here. So this is your past here, guys. Okay. Let's have a look at your present. So tell me for group two, please, what is this card making a choice? What do we need to know about this card? Thank you. So we've got Eight of Pentacles, Two of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles. This is great. And the Seven of Cups in reverse. You're finally back to reality now. There's no more of this. You're finally finding peace. And I feel like for group two here, all you're doing is trying to put your life back together. You're working really hard on yourself. You're working really hard at work. You know, you've had to maybe juggle putting your finances back together and juggling your life at the same time, and maybe career, family, if you've got family with this person here, over here. Yeah, you're working really hard on yourself. But it also could be, if you haven't done this already, so making the choice is weighing up your options. And this is what I said with this card. You're at a fork in the road now. It's a decision. I can't even friggin' say it. Hang on, let me take a drink, because my mouth is really dry. I've been talking so much. God. It's decision time, okay? Oh, I think you knew what I was trying to say anyway. You're taking responsibility for yourself, for your life. It's, you're not even blaming this other person. You may feel hurt. You may feel wounded with what they did to you, but you're not holding on to that anymore. You're wanting to let it go. You know, you see, with the Six of Pentacles, this could be you working really hard because maybe you've got debt with this person over here. So, you know, trying to sort out your finances, pay off debt collectors, loans and things like that. So maybe you're even juggling two jobs at the moment. But you're not sitting there saying, woe is me. Oh, my God, they put me in this position. No, you're taking responsibility for your life, for your actions. So tell me, Spirit, what is the, tell me about the choice here, please, for group two. look what's just come out again. Seven of Cups. Why? Oh, okay. Seven of Cups in reverse. This has come out twice now, Spirit. Tell me about it, please. You know, we know you're back to reality. You found a solution. Five of Swords. Three of Swords. Page of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles. Knight of Cups. You know what, it is actually really nice to see, you know, from what I've been saying, to see the Five of Swords here, because this actually says that nobody won here, okay? You're both lost in this connection. You're not blaming them. They may be blaming you, but you're not blaming them. You're taking, like I keep saying, you're taking responsibility for what went wrong. You're owning the fact that, you know, the relationship ended with the Three of Swords. It is heartbreak. And you are dealing with that heartbreak, or you may have already dealt with that heartbreak. It's like you've now come to the realization that the person that you were actually with was someone that was full of empty promises, somebody that couldn't stick to the truth, somebody that couldn't be honest with you, okay? They couldn't be who you wanted them to be. Very childish, very immature, like I said, very aggressive. Someone who plays games all the time. But then we have the Ten of Pentacles here. So I feel like the path that you've got, two choices, you know, we have the two, it's like the Two of Wands. So if you were to stay with this person over here, if you made that choice of staying to try and work it out, trying to fix things with them, you're just going to feel defeated. You're just going to feel run down. This, you know, the Five of Swords is somebody that's in an abusive relationship, okay, or is being bullied, is not being treated well. You know, your heart is going to be broken over this. Because this person can't give you what you want. They're not emotionally available or mature enough. And then you have that choice that if you were to leave this person behind, you've got a Ten of Pentacles right here, which is guaranteed. Your finances are going to start looking really, really healthy. You know, you could end up in a relationship that's guaranteed, that you'll grow old together. It's success here. But I feel like the choice when you made it, you left this behind here, and you're, you know, with the work here, this is going to lead, I'm going to put them there, guys. This is going to lead to your Ten of Pentacles right here, finally. And I feel like you're going to do it all on your own. Nobody is going to be helping you with this. This is all going to be you. I mean, it's the best card in the deck other than the Ace of Pentacles. Tell me about this Ten of Pentacles for Group 2, please, Spirit. Knight of Swords and the Hangman. Why the Knight of Swords? Look what's come out, literally clarifies that oracle card, the Two of Wands, a decision that you guys need to make. So look, we've got here the Knight of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. look, you accept that you were reckless in the past with your behaviour or the choices that you made here. And sometimes you've got to be reckless, you know, now. You know, sometimes it's... Spirit is saying this is an opportunity to be reckless, okay? If this is the path that you want to go down, the big change that you're about to bring into your life here is going to bring about this Ten of Pentacles, which is guaranteed wealth, something that you can leave to your children here. You've been enlightened to, you know, that situation over there. You've been shown the fact that, you know, the situation you were in was toxic. It was not healthy for you. And I feel like one day you just woke up and you decided, that's it, I'm done, I'm leaving. Hence the Reckless card, hence the Eight of Wands here. This is somebody that takes swift action, you know, you're very quick and you're just gone. So you made this choice very quickly. And now you're in this, like, you're feeling happy. And I said this with that card, it's about something that's wonderful that's about to approach you guys here. So you've got your Three of Cups, you're feeling happy, you're going out, you're socializing more, you know, you're making new friends, you're meeting up with old friends here. You're in the Queen of Wands, you're someone who is very powerful, you're strong, you're independent. So you're loving your independence at the moment. You're feeling confident, you're feeling sexy, you're feeling attractive. Because you got your power back. You know, you're feeling really passionate about your new start here. It could be that you're starting to travel. Maybe that's what you wanted to do. Have a look. So now let's look at your future here. You know, what you've got to be careful of, guys, okay, is that if you were to hold back and stay in this situation here and you want to give it a go and you want to, you know, fix things with your partner here, you could end up losing out on the Ten of Pentacles. You're going to be someone who is very successful, but you're going to make that success on your own. I see nobody else here except you guys. I don't see no help. Maybe friends will help, you know, encourage you along the way, but it's all you. So we've got Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. Very strong fire sign in this reading. So let's have a look at the... Oh, Oregon's lair. So tell me about the lair, please, for group two. Queen of Cups. Tell me about the Queen of Cups. Queen of Pentacles in reverse. Six of Swords in reverse. Six of Wands, victory, success. Ace of Swords. This is a huge achievement. This is... Hang on, guys. There's somebody here, which has come out of nowhere, who is very ungrounded and shallow that you could be dealing with. And this Queen of Pentacles in reverse tends to take advantage of the Queen of Cups here, which is you guys, because your nature is very kind, you're very caring, you're very soft. Once again, this is the intuition card here. So your intuition, if you're feeling off vibes about this Queen of Pentacles, whoever she is. I will clarify it. Listen to that, because like I said, it's like your alarm system. But this Queen of Pentacles, why am I picking up mother-in-law? Oh, please don't. Is about to bring trouble into your life. But what is really nice to see is the Six of Wands, and this is you being recognized for something. This is you, you know, standing in your power and also being much stronger than this Queen of Pentacles here. Tell me about the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. I mean, this can be your, can be this past person here that may want to bring a bit of trouble towards you here, because they see you moving on into the future here with the Ten of Pentacles. So we have the Page of Wands, Five of Swords again, and the Seven of Cups upright this time, and the King of Swords has come back. This is your ex again. This is the past person here, because we have the King of Swords that has literally come out twice. This person, I feel like this person still hasn't really let you go. I mean, it could be that they're in your energy as well, but this is someone that is very wicked, very jealous of your success. So they're about to bring some kind of trouble here. They don't want you to have this success here with the Five of Swords. They want you to fail. They want you to fail. They want you to feel confused. And you know what? They've been looking at you for a very long time, okay? So if it's been a while, this person's been watching you, studying you, maybe looking at what you're up to see how they can affect your success. Oh, what are they up to, Spirit? This is supposed to be something good here. Tell me about the Five of Swords. What are they up to? What does Group 2 need to be wary of? Come on, Spirit, please. What do they need to know about this King of Cups, Knight of Wands, Eight of Pentacles again? Oh my goodness. Oh, Three of Swords again. Oh my goodness. Bear with me, guys, because I'm just, it's getting on my nerves. I'm still not getting a clear message from Spirit here. What is going on here, Spirit, please? Just bear with me. What is going on? So we've got the Queen of Cups again. And then we've got the Knight of Swords in reverse. Page of Wands again. Look, I feel like where you matured here with this 19 card, you know, once again, we've got bullying again. It's like you guys literally were out of your depth here. It was like you didn't know how to handle this situation. You didn't know how to handle this person. And I'm picking up very strongly here that this person is still in your energy, even if they're not in your life anymore. They're in your energy here and they're still affecting you in some kind of way that's affecting your future here. It's making you feel very confused, very unbalanced, like you're not in alignment with yourself. Tell me, what is this energy doing to group two? What are they doing? What are they doing, spirit, to group two? So maybe you've been feeling out of sorts or something like that. Three of wands. Oh my goodness. The world. It's like they want you to learn a lesson. They need you to learn a lesson. And I feel like the lesson is, you shouldn't have left me. They don't want you to be successful here with the Five of Coins. They want you to struggle. They want you to, I don't know why I heard that, starve. Okay, for some of you, maybe you guys have immigrated, okay? Because we do have two immigration cards here. So maybe this person is trying to stop you from immigrating. You know, it could be you've got children with them. So they're trying to prevent this from happening. So some of you may actually want to leave the country. So they're trying to prevent this from you leaving. But you know what's really nice to see here as well? It's like, you know, from what I said, you have evolved, you have learned some valuable lessons in this whole relationship here, this whole situation. And the chapters, it's closed now. But it's like this person can't seem to let go. It's kind of creepy. It's like trap. I'm hearing trap. And that might be, you know, a lair is somebody's, you know, it's like a dragon lair or what, you know what I mean? And that could be why this person is doing something maybe spiritually, or it's just in your energy here, and they're affecting your life, maybe your thoughts, the way you're feeling. Maybe they're actually still involved with you. So tell me more about this Oregon's lair. What? Tell me more for this, about this Oregon lair for group three. Here we go, finally. Yeah, look at this. So we have the wish card here, and I like that, because I said to you about the Oregon's lair there, that a long held dream or a big wish fulfillment or something that you've been manifesting is beginning. You're at the beginning, so you could be ending this cycle with this person, okay, all this negative energy here, and it's just like at the beginning of it here. So whatever you've been wishing for is about to happen. This is happiness, success. You got two aces here, mental clarity, being truthful to yourself as well. It could be truths coming out about the situation here, but I feel like it's more you being truthful with yourself. The Ace of Cups is all about love, second chances at finding love, you know, a genuine love where you can settle down with that person and the feelings are mutual, you know, mutual respect. Tell me about this Ace of Cups and this Ace of Swords and Ace of Cups. You could have been waiting for, like, remember I said at the beginning that look for the signs, okay? You've been being shown signs, watch out for them. So this wish fulfillment, this thing that you've been manifesting and wanting, the Ace of Swords is like you being shown something, you know, the truth, or, you know, just look for those signs, okay? It's something to do with this Ace of Cups. So tell me about this Ace of Cups, please, Spirit. Tell me about the Ace of Cups. Oh, this turned out to be really awkward. Death. Seven of Wands. Page of Swords. The Hierophant. And the Queen of Wands. And the Fool. You're about to have a breakthrough here when it comes to love or commitments, or just, you know, overall loving yourself. It doesn't have to be a commitment if that's not what you want. Look, Spirit wants you here to protect yourself with the Seven of Wands, with the Page of Swords. Protect yourself from spying eyes, okay? Watchful eyes. Because whoever this person is, which I feel like is an ex, is somehow managing to spy on you. Could be asking friends, could be looking on your social media, maybe they've got fake accounts. This person can still send you negative energy by looking at your photographs online, okay? Things that you post. They can send it just, as, you know, it's the evil eye. So this might be this someone that is managing to affect your energy in that way, okay? Because they want you to experience endings and, you know, failure, and, you know, they don't want you to move on. You could have been married to this person. But it also could be somebody that takes advantage of uses more, is of dark, you know, like the devil energy, somebody that doesn't, they're not of light, okay? This is what I'm picking up here. Somebody that may dabble in the occult, but the dark arts, if you know what I mean. So just be careful, okay? Because we do have the spine card, we do have protect yourself, we do have endings here. You've got the Queen of Wands again. You are the Queen of Wands. You are somebody that is very strong, powerful. You can handle this. You know, you've got your brand new beginning here with the Fool. Don't let this person stop you from having a brand new beginning. So what advice would you give group two? Oh, this one really confused me, honestly. What advice would you give group two? Nine of Coins in reverse and the Fool. You may be lacking funds at the moment, you know, you may be lacking security or, you know, independence. You know, it may be slow to come because, like I said, you're working very hard at the moment. I feel like you're trying to build your finances back up. So what is the advice about the Nine of Coins in reverse? Tell me about the Nine of Coins in reverse, please, Spirit. Six of Swords in reverse. We actually got that twice. Six of Swords in reverse twice. Trouble is on its way. So you may experience a bit of trouble when it comes to your finances, okay? Things may be slow to start. It may be that your finances are doing very well, but you're missing your 10th pentacle, which is that love. Your 10th pentacle was there when I did the cards at the beginning. So you may be having trouble trying to sort out debt here, because there was the debt that I saw there. Tell me more, please. What advice would you give group two in regards to Six of Swords and the Nine of Pentacles in reverse? Knight of Coins. Look, manifestation. Four of Wands, happiness. Look, Spirit is saying, look, even the Eight of Pentacles on the back of this deck as well. Slow and steady wins the race, okay? You know, like the turtle and the hare, turtle one. You don't need to rush anything. Don't rush nothing here. It will happen for you. Keep working on yourself. Keep working hard. You may be experiencing some setbacks at the moment. It could even be because this person's sending you, and I'll take that as a confirmation with my dog going into one. I was going to say, this person's sending you the evil eye. Okay, and I don't know whether you heard my dog. That sounded quite nasty. She's not really. She's just an idiot. The Spirit's saying you have the tools and the gifts that were given to you. You're someone who is very powerful. You're someone who is a very powerful manifester here. So this, your dream is within your grasp here. Success is right there. Just don't give up. Keep going. But I don't see you guys as people that give up anyway, because you've come through as quite strong. But what concerns me is about, that's why I've taken so long on your pile. It's very confusing, and I feel like it's this energy. And I'm really shocked that the devil didn't come out. Page of Swords again. Honestly, you have eyes on you. You need to protect yourself, group two, because I feel like this is what's affecting your progress here. So let's get some angel cards for you for a bit of advice. So for group two. So we have do the work. It's not enough to dream or pray. You've also got to take the positive action steps that you are being divinely guided to take. Consistently working on your priorities will make them flourish like a lush flower garden. Exactly. And I feel like that is what you're doing. You're working really, really hard, you know, on yourself, on your career, on your finances. I'm going to take this one. Clearing debts. I said that. Your self-care involves removing the heavy burden of financial and emotional debts from your life. You already feel lighter and freer just by facing this topic and making a plan to clear present obligations and avoid future ones as well. Yep. I've literally said that. Thanks for clarifying, Spirit. I've got a funny feeling here with this King of Swords and this King of Cups again. You can't make this stuff up. The cards were literally repeating themselves, and I used three different decks here just to see whether it was me, you know, having a problem, because sometimes, you know, you get a mental block. But I feel like there is a big warning here that this King of Cups is trying to affect your future, but it could also be that this person just literally took everything from you, or left you with everything, you know, the debt and everything. Let's get one more. And the sad thing is as well, group two, that they're still playing these mind games with you. They may not be verbally talking to you, but there's mind games going on. There's manipulation going on. There's something going on here that's not right. Have courage to ask for help and accept help. Asking for help is a sign of strength, as in accepting it as it is offered to you. Very often when you ask God for help, prayers are answered through other people. Be sure to accept this assistance as well as give it to others as you are guided. So basically, guys, if you need help, You have friends and family here that are willing to help you. You know, if you're feeling like you're stuck in a rut and you feel like you're overwhelmed, ask for help, you know. And then just remember, like Spirit just said in that card, is just remember these people that helped you. And sometimes God or the angels and spirit guides and that send you people as their way of showing you this, these are who we want to help you. So just ask for that assistance. Ask for that help. Okay. So we have, show the world the real you, full moon in Aquarius. Conclusions are within reach. And I said that I feel like you're right at the end of that journey there. This long journey, this hard slog that you've been on. Hold your vision. Surrender to the divine, full moon again, fixed moon. And the energy is gaining momentum. And the energy is that you're on that precipice. You're ready to take that leap with the fall, you know. So group two, I'm going to leave it there. Hope this resonated for you. If you like the reading, please hit like. I appreciate you. I mean, you have a lovely, you have a lovely evening, guys. I'll see you soon. Much love. Hey, group three. So if you chose this pink pin, this is your reading. So let's have a look. We have number 18, Magic Stream. 24, Stuck in the Mud. And 25, metamorphosis, whatever. We all know what that means. So we have past, present, future. So with the past, with you guys, group three, you've not had an easy time. Okay, with all these three cards here that I'm seeing is that you are stuck in old beliefs. Okay, it could be that you're stuck in a job that you don't like, a relationship you don't like, or just the beliefs that you believe in. It's like there's no flow. It's like I'm picking up a very ungrounded energy here in the past. Even though it says magic stream, it's like you're very hopeful about things. Okay, you know, you're hoping for something to happen or to turn out in a certain way, but it doesn't seem to work out that way for you. And then what happens with the present here, you've become stuck in the mud here. It's like you're just plodding along, and it's like, is there any way out of this? But Spirit is saying that sometimes it's time to maybe change the way you look at things or change old habits here. Sometimes it's like a death with this card as well, you know, because you have the cocoon. Obviously, you know, a butterfly comes from a cocoon first. And once that hatches, then you're a butterfly, and then, you know, you've blossomed. So there is something that is blocking you here, group three. Something that there's a huge blockage here. Let's get some tarot cards and find out what this blockage is for you guys, okay? Oh, crap. That's going to go flying. Okay, let's have a look. So tell me about this magic stream for group three, please, Spirit. I'm going to clarify each card and see what's going on for your past here. So tell me about this magic stream, please. Okay. So we have the Page of Wands. So tell me more about the magic stream. Oh my goodness me. Eight of Pentacles. Five of Swords. Four of Cups. And the Devil. This is a work situation, okay? I feel like you just feel like you're just plodding along and nothing's happening for you here. You know, and it's like, you know, the Page of Wands is studying hard, working really hard, you know, perfecting the craft or the, you know, the career that you've got here. And you are a really, really hard worker, but it's like instead of, you know, with that stream card there, instead of you just floating down the stream, it's like this struggle that you've got to fight against the tide or, you know, the current here. And it's like you worked really hard, but all it's brought you is nothing but you feeling depressed, defeated, like, I feel like I'm wasting my time here. You know, you could be experiencing also bullying at work. You know, maybe you're surrounded by a lot of toxic people. We do have the devil here. This is you feeling so dissatisfied with your life. Very dissatisfied with your life. But it could be that you've become obsessed with maybe ignoring the truth. You know, maybe you've just become the type of person that is like, well, you know, I'm here now, I might as well stay instead of dealing with the situation. It could be that you are very dependent on, you know, the income. Maybe you know that if you were to move jobs, you may end up taking a cut. So maybe it's the money that's keeping you there, you know, because money, the devil is all about greed as well. But you're feeling very dissatisfied here. And you are somebody who is very intelligent. You know, the Queen of Swords. Very intelligent. So we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius here. And we also have Capricorn. So, tell me about the devil, please. About the devil. Yeah, burdens. Tell me about the devil. Pentacles. Ten of Pentacles. Five of Wands. Your environment at work has become very toxic. You're not getting on with the people that you work with. You could be finding it that people are just picking on you, attacking you, excluding you as well. The environment has become very toxic. You are experiencing some kind of bullying here within the workplace. You're being left out in the cold here. You know? And it's... you guys, I feel really bad for you guys here. This is really not a nice place to be working in. You're stressed, you're exhausted. And it's like you feel to yourself here, because you know, you've got the Ten of Pentacles, you've built up a good reputation for yourself, you've built up, you know, some solid wealth here with the Ten of Pentacles. So maybe it's got to the stage where your, you know, spirit might be saying to you, is that not enough, the Ten of Pentacles? Sometimes our health is more valuable than coin. You know, it could be that you're not even spending time with family at the moment, if you've got a family, you know, children, a partner, and you're having to leave them in the cold as well, because you've become so career orientated here, obsessed with this here. You know, it's like, I feel like this stems from your childhood here, that you were just never good enough. And it's like you're trying to prove something to other people and even yourself here, Group 3. But Spirit is saying, what are you trying to prove here? So you're having an internal war right now with yourself as well. And this is really, really sad, you know. So let's look at the present. I've got caught on the bloody jumper there. Right. Tell me about Stuck in the Mud for Group 3, please, Spirit. Look at this. Ace of Pentacles. Tell me about this Stuck in the Mud, place spirit. Death. Spirit is saying, enough is enough now. You're not stuck in this situation. You have a choice, okay? Your destiny is in your hands, and spirit is giving you this chance here to start again. You know, if you're fearful of maybe not having enough, spirit is saying you will have enough. You've got more than enough here. I mean, I love this card, the way the coin is in the hands here. And like I said, this could stem from your childhood. Maybe you come from a poor background, you know? I come from a poor background. And you're so fearful of not having enough. But it's not good for you guys. You guys are coming out as the devil. You know? It's time to change. It's time to end maybe this obsession with finances or being better. You don't need to do that, because the Ace of Pentacles is a brand new beginning here. Spirit is saying there's a new job on the horizon for you. If you want to make this move, make the move. Use your intuition here with the moon. If it's telling you, your intuition, that it doesn't feel right, this is not good for me no more, it's not healthy for me, your dreams could even be telling you that this is not good for you, it's time to make this change. It's time to find a balance in your life now. You don't need to be stuck in this situation anymore. So tell me more about the Ace of Pentacles and death, please. I don't know whether you can hear a lot of screeching and stuff, but my daughter's got a friend over and I don't know what they're doing right now. Oh my God, here goes all the doors. I don't know if you lot got kids, but you know when they start slamming doors. Yeah, look, walk away. You know, you've got... I've got the five of wands again. You're fighting with yourself, group three. It's a battle with yourself. And it's this huge fear. You know, Eight of Cups is leaving it behind, you know, moving on to something better. And I feel like this is something better for you guys. Yeah, it may not pay the same amount of money, but your mental health and your happiness is what is going to be important to you guys. You're not stuck, is what Spirit's saying. You're really not. Go within. You'll find the answers. Spend some time on your own. Maybe meditate. So tell me a bit more, please, Spirit, about this stuck in the mud. Wow. Nine of Swords. Five of Cups, Page of Pentacles, and the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, look, your problem, the fear is with you guys, is that you know you're going to have to start from the bottom and work your way up again. Or even if it ain't working from the bottom and working your way up, it may be that you need to show whoever your new boss is, or the company or whatever that you want to work for, that you're here to stay and you want to lay down roots and you want to grow with the company, okay? You are somebody who is very loyal, and these people, if you do move on, will notice the loyalty that you bring to the company. But you've got this Five of Cups and this Nine of Swords here. The walking away is stressing you out. You're not sleeping, you're not eating, you're stressing out. You may be having nightmares about it here, because there's this fear of you feeling rejected, not wanted. Maybe you can't find another job, maybe nobody's gonna want me, you know, all that comes with it. But look at this, the Nine of Pentacles. This is you doing so well for yourself. You know, Nine of Pentacles is success and reaping the rewards, you know, financial rewards. Look at... So if you look here, you've gone from walking away, stressing out, you know, showing the company that you're loyal here with these two cards, you know, showing that you want to grow with them, and then look at the happiness on her face. So this will be your energy once you take that, you know, take that leap, you know, if that's what you guys want to do. So let's have a look at metamorphosis. So tell me about metamorphosis, please, spirit. I'm so glad your pile is so much easier. Jeez, my pile twos is always complicated. I mean, honestly, I was there for ages trying to figure out what the heck was going on. So we've got the Knight of Pentacles. So tell me more about the metamorphosis here, please, spirit. You know, metamorphosis is you changing into something beautiful, you know. Yeah, look at this, Four of Pentacles, Three of Cups, a partnership, Six of Wands, victory, success, the world. We've got her again, Queen of Swords. You're back out again, guys. I mean, these are beautiful cards. So if you were willing to take that chance, okay, you know, you may have been thinking about it for so long with the Knight of Pentacles, because this is somebody that likes to plan things out. You know, you like to do it in a correct way instead of just rushing into something, which is, it is a good thing. You know, if the Knight of Swords was here, I'd say calm down a bit. Don't be rash. So yeah, you've taken your time. You're thinking about it, because don't forget, this is the future card. And you know it may be an uphill battle or a struggle to get to where you were in, say, this company with this company, but it's going to be rewarding in the end. You're so fearful of change with the Four of Pentacles. That's fear of change, okay? But you've got this desire to feel wanted, to feel secure in an environment. Like I said, there could have been bullying in your job in the past. But we've got the Three of Cups. This is a soul family that you're about to enter here. These are going to become friends of yours. These are going to be people that you've never worked with before, okay? And they're going to feel like family to you. This is a contract here with the Lovers. This is not love. This is, you know, this is a contract. This is a partnership. So you could be offered a long-term contract with this company, or, you know, a partnership here. I mean, look at her with the Six of Wands. This is victory. This is success. It's a new job. You know, this is you being recognized for all the hard work or the gifts that you bring to this company. This could even be a promotion here, you know, like to you becoming manager or something. And I love this world card, because again, look how happy she is. You know, you finally, I feel like once you get to this stage, you've completed your destiny, okay? You're where you're supposed to be, and this is what this whole reading is about. It's time to close out this chapter here, and it's time to complete the path that you're supposed to be on. So let's get a bit of advice for you. So what advice would you give Group Three, please, spirit? Okay, so we have the Wheel, Judgment, Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Cups, Page of Swords, Six of Pentacles. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Spirit saying to you, the advice to you is you need to make a decision, okay? It's time to act now. Your fortune is about to change. The Wheel is going to turn in your favor, because she's sitting on top of the Wheel. Now, if it was like this, I'd say to you, oh, be a bit careful, you know, things may not be going in your favor here. But you're on top of the world, okay? You're on top of the Wheel. So time to make a decision, act upon it. You bring value to this company, okay, and they're going to see your value. You know, this is somebody that, you know, can be a manager or a business owner. She is successful, the Queen of Pentacles. And this is you guys here. You're very abundant, okay? So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We've got Gemini. We've got, what else we got? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. A strong air, strong earth sign in this reading as well. So, you know, you're valuable. Spirit wants you to use your intuition. When you go for this job or when you decide to leave, trust in that intuition, because the Queen of Cups has very good intuition. You know, she's also a psychic as well. So listen to that, you know, maybe you're having psychic dreams. Listen to that inner voice, okay? And with the Page of Swords, you know, you've studied really hard to get where you are. You know, maybe what you need to do as well is also maybe before you go for any kind of job, do a bit of investigation, do a bit of snooping, you know, see what this company is all about, and then use your intuition to see whether it's right for you, because this is going to lead to success here with the Six of Pentacles. This is going to be equal partnership. It's not going to be one-sided. Everybody is going to be, you know, giving and taking, and but it's going to be equal. Yeah, you've got a bright future here. A very bright future. So let's see what your angels say here for you, Group 3. So tell me, what would you like to tell Group 3? Organize for success. Do not let the word organize intimidate you, as it is simply a way for you to ensure clarity of purpose. Organizing your thoughts, your reports, your living and workspace, and your finances will help you know and plan your next action and steps. That's like the Knight of Pentacles. Plan it, organize it, spy, have a nosy, look at this company online, you know, get the information that you want or that you need. Pay yourself first. Make yourself the most important financial obligation by setting aside a portion of your income every time you are paid. This loving form of self-care ensures that you'll have savings to invest in your present and your future. Now, that could be what, like I said, if you guys come from, I don't even like to say poor background, or just like, you know, like I said, I came from a very poor background, you know, work was very important. So, you know, when you've got the money, if you're worried about finances, Spirit is saying here, these angels are saying it because these are angel cards, put a little bit away for like a little nest egg, you know, just so if anything does go wrong, you've got something to fall back on, and then you're not going to be stressing yourself out that you're going to be struggling to pay rent or eat, you know, that kind of thing. Clearing debts. Your self-care involves removing the heavy burden of financial and emotional debts from your life. You already feel lighter and freer just by freeing this topic and making a plan to clear present obligations and avoid future ones as well. And this might be what this is. This past year, it could be you were dealing with karmics here. I feel like with you, Group 3, finances are very important to you. Why not? There's nothing wrong with that. But Spirit is saying you really don't need to worry. It's very positive, this reading. And then face your financial... Oh my goodness me. Honestly, good. Oh God. When you are honest with yourself about fears of success or failure, they can no longer control you. Be free of hidden fears by exposing them to the light of awareness, and you'll realize that you in fact have nothing to fear, and that every successful person has struggled with and released these self-doubts. There you go. I mean, come on, this whole reading has been about finances and career, and now your angel cards are saying the, oh my goodness, so look what's on the back of the deck. Sever the vows of poverty. Now you had the poverty card twice. Dear one, there's no need to suffer or sacrifice. Hold the intention of undoing any vows of poverty or self-denial that you may have made, consciously or unconsciously, in any lifetime. As you do so, all effects of these vows will be undone for everyone involved in all directions of time. Now, for some of you, okay, it could be your past here as well. The job that you're in the past, or was in, you know, you studied hard, you worked hard, but there may not have been any progression in the company. You may have been overlooked, you may have been ignored, you may have been paid craply, you know. And now, it's like maybe you feel like I'm not deserving, or there's nothing better out there for me. And now I want to stay here because I feel secure, because this is stemming from your childhood. I'm really am picking up quite strongly group three, okay? But spirit is saying, let go of all these financial fears, because there's this lovely new start here in the future for you guys, with something that is going to be very rewarding financially and emotionally for you. And if you are really scared about being poor, and I'm going to say poor because I can't think of anything else, put a little bit away for yourselves. I'll do that. Shove a little bit away every now and again, you know, as you do, because you just never know, really. So for group three, please, spirit. So communication is key. Yeah, I feel like you need to have a talk. I don't feel like communication with anybody else. I feel like it's maybe you need to communicate to, you know, these self-doubts and fears to yourself, as well as maybe to spirit as well. So we have, what do you need to release? You know what you need to release. It's come out over and over. Balance, spirituality and practicality. Full moon in Pisces. The end of a tough cycle approaches. Full moon in Capricorn. Win-win outcome is forecast. You're very close to achieving your goal. Have faith in your dreams. Okay? So, I'm going to leave it there, group three. If this resonated, please hit like. And you have a lovely evening. Much love, guys.